you believe in luck?
I do believe in luck. I mean, sir, as per you, then you say that circumstances doesn't play a role in it?
You see, what I'm sharing with you is, life is full of choices and life is full of compromises. Now, you might say this is a contradiction, but really not. See, if I ill-treat you, Vishnu, I've chosen to be ill-treated, haven't I? If I treat you with discourtesy, I've chosen to be treated with discourtesy, haven't I? If I light up a cigarette, I've chosen to invite cancer, haven't I? See, life is full of choices. Now, hear this. We are all free to the point of choice. But after we make our choices, the choice controls the chooser. We have no more choice. Choice stops right there. Now, the next question comes, how is life full of compromises? See, question is everything in life within our control? Answer is no. It's not. I didn't choose my parents, neither did you. I didn't decide where I was going to be born, neither did you. If this is my height, I cannot be 6'10". That's the way it is. If this is the color of my skin, there's nothing I can do. Granted, sometimes people are born deformed. Sometimes bad things do happen to good people for no fault of their own. What wrong did they do? Who knows? As somebody said, well, we cannot choose the cards that are dealt to us. What we can choose is how we play the game in life. And sometimes nature gives us a lemon. That is true. Choice is ours. Do we cry or do we make lemonade? That is our choice. See, it is not our position. It is our disposition that determines success. What is disposition? Disposition is our attitude. Which brings to the point, how come under the same set of circumstances, some people break records while others break themselves? Think about it.
I'm going to ask the young people, do you believe in religion?
Definitely.
Definitely, sir. Yes. Basically, you can align what you believe, I mean, what you believe about yourself and what others believe about you, or what you believe about your religion. The more compatible these things are, the more successful you will be.
Sir, believing in religion, see, it's again, as I said before, it's the perception of an individual it takes. And it is your ability or to comprehend that and translate it in your life. So if again, it's a religion, I do believe in religion, but then I am not superstitious in the same manner. I do believe which I can see and feel it.
So, is there a contradiction between religion and what Shiv Khera says? Because religion tells you that there is a certain predestiny, whereas he says you can change yourself.
So I believe God is not made us like puppets. He doesn't have strings attached to us to move us the way he wants.
Well.
He gives us our freedom to make choices.
Very well said.
So I believe our destiny is in our hands. We design our own fate.
What is your view on religion?
In fact,
I see you've got all the threads in your hand. You believe in a religion.
I haven't been to a temple in the last 40 years. Let me share with you. But I do pray. I do believe in God. No question about that. Now, let me share. See, when you go to pray, in fact, invariably you find when people pray, what is one thing they say? With God's power, everything is possible. That's what they say. Now you pray that and you come out, and whenever something comes up and you say, I can't do this, all of a sudden inside you said, with God's power, everything is possible, and you come out, I cannot do this. Tell me, aren't we created by God? And are we not created in the image of God? Then are those powers not flowing through us? Now, the only thing I would like to share here is, most people go to religious places not out of faith, but out of fear. You don't do this, this will happen. You don't do this, this will happen. You don't do this, this will bad will happen. And you know something? That is sad. That is really sad. That is manipulation of religion, outright, in my opinion. See, going out of faith is very different to going out of fear. And I think 90% people, temple-going people, are going out of fear. It's not out of faith. And there's a huge difference.
So, there is a saying in Sanskrit, Karmanya Vadikaraste Ma Faleshu Kadachin. Lord Krishna told it to Arjun. You need to go on and do your work. The results will automatically follow. Again, any choice we make, there is a, what do you say, there is an assumption or there is a result to it. You can, it's simple. If you don't smoke, you'll not get cancer. If you smoke, you will get cancer. There are two ways. the destiny, which I feel, in either ways, the destiny is always written. It is the way which we wanted to do it. If I work hard, I'll win. That is there. It's a natural phenomenon. If it's work hard, it's then you will achieve your goals. If you're not working hard, you're not achieving your goals. The starting point and the end point is written. The only thing is the distance we travel. So according to that, then how can we say that destiny is not written? I mean, which everything is preliminarily, or what you say, it is already calculated that this will happen if you do this.
Do you believe in astrology?
No, I don't.
Why is that?
In fact, if you look at the life histories of people like Swami Vivekanand, Swami Dayanand, Guru Nanak, they never believed in any of these superstitions. In fact, that's what Vishnu just said. And in fact, you look at all the Sikh weddings, and in fact, for that matter, Christian weddings, they all take place on Sundays. They don't have anything manglik, they don't have any patris, they don't have any of those other things happening. How come? They never believed in all these things. And I find that today it weakens people. It is actually weakening people. Every channel you open today, every TV channel, every newspaper you open up at night and opening up in the morning, they give you a lucky color, lucky number, lucky this, lucky that. And they say, give you, get out of your house, don't turn left, make a right. And if a cat crosses, stop. This is ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. Do they have divine powers? Absolutely not. And in fact, the same people who bring out all these things, that your nakshatra is not meeting, your patris are not meeting, you figure this upai, do 20 things here, and they'll resolve all your problems. How come all of a sudden they are agents of God? They can change your destiny in 1 minute. They write your destiny, second minute, they change your destiny. Who are they?
But sir, how can you so easily judge them and dismiss them as fixtures?
I am sharing with you Swami Dayanand, Swami Vivekanand, and Guru Nanak. I agree with their philosophy. Made sense. Makes sense to me. I know when I got married 40 plus years ago, my parents never checked out all these things. My daughter got married, we never checked out all these things. We never checked out their patris, we never checked out their date of birth, we never took out any mahurat. When should they be getting married? It was just, they said, well, this is a convenient time. I said, go right ahead, move. That's it.
Payal.
Yes, sir.
Have you ever had doubts in your life?
Obviously, sir.
A doubt that you may not be able to win.
Yes,
you may not be able to score good marks.
Yes, sir.
So what would you do when you have a doubt?
So basically, I would like to put in my best of efforts. Whatever result I get that is not in my hand, but doing the best is in my hand.
Absolutely. You had these doubts, did you try to motivate yourself saying,
yes,
I am
sir.
The greatest?
Yes, sir.
I can
obviously,
win.
I mean, I very frequently say that I can is always more important than your IQ.
Absolutely.
That is what motivates me a lot.
I was stating on that, sir, even the modern scientists have said that astrology is a science. It's not purely a 100% thing, but there are certain calculations which is evident from the, if you start from the ancient times, even the Mahabharata, even the Ramayana. I mean, these are all what you say. See, our life, if I say my life, is a 50% of my work and my beliefs. See, some speakers have said like that. I'm not disagreeing into it. But then there are other learned people who have agreed that astrological is a science and it can be trusted upon. So what is your take on that?
I mentioned in my book, you just mentioned about the Ramayana. In fact, when Ram and Sita got married, they pulled out the most auspicious time. And right after marriage, his father died. They were thrown out of the kingdom and went out to jungle 14 years. All of a sudden, everything got destroyed and Ravan took away Sita, kidnapped her. Everything messed up right that minute. And it was supposed to have been the most auspicious time. What happened? Now, besides, I mentioned in my book, Freedom is Not Free. A few years ago, there was an astrological conference globally. Well, not global, but maybe India. And they figured out that in Jaipur it was done. I mentioned in my book, Freedom is Not Free, that the next 12 months are not auspicious for marriages and something of that nature. And all of a sudden, these people realized that if marriages are not going to take place, what about our income? Then they say, oh, no, we need to do something and revise everything and change it to a few months. What is this? This is ridiculous. And you go back into now, as far as the Ramayana, Mahabharata, those are mythologies. We don't even know if they existed. But now come to the historical part. Go back into our history. maybe the Battle of Panipat and a few others that took place, we were four times the forces of the Mughals, four times. And the astrologer said it's not a good time to fight. And sitting ducks, they killed everybody sitting there. What happened? Now, if we don't learn lessons from history, then we are doomed anyway. And that's exactly what it is.
Somewhere along the line, you have said, Shiv, that time is constant. That, and we pass through it. Or true. Words to that effect.
Yeah.
Does that not go against it? The theory of relativity, of Einstein's principles of time,
well,
space, dimension?
Not really. You see, the bottom line is, we people keep saying time keeps comes and goes away. Answer is really not. Time does not come and go away. We come and go away. And that's it. And invariably, you keep hearing people telling time management ought to be important, time management. Well, there's no such thing known as time management. You see, it is when we waste time, what are we wasting? Our lives. So really, a time management is only a name given to life management, and that's really bottom line is.
Would you agree there's something called time management? Most of your MBA students, time management is part of your curriculum and something you swear by.
We do agree on management of time. Time management is basically how you manage each and every second that you're spending.
Yeah.
So how you add value to each and every moment of your life, that is basically time management.
Well, I believe, sir, time management, in fact, the very concept came into play because at this era of ours, the one thing that we do not have is time. We humans do not have the luxury of time. Nobody has time. Nobody has time for humanity. Nobody has time for each other. That's where we all go wrong. So I believe time management is definitely a crucial aspect that we all need to spend time and effort into.
Absolutely. I totally agree with you. And interestingly, never in the history of mankind have we had so many time-saving devices that we have today. And in spite of so many time-saving devices,
we have no time.
If you permit me, in fact, I'm writing a notation on, in fact, an article that the way technology is changing today, the speed of change that is happening today, forget people like me with white hair, even the younger generation is finding it hard to keep up with technology today. And every class that graduates today, it's a little more knowledgeable than the previous one, at least it's supposed to be. But that's a positive side. But the flip side is, within 2 years, their knowledge will become obsolete also.
What about values? In this fast-moving world, values seem to be the first that's compromised. You think you can win in life without values?
No, sir. Actually, you know what's happening? It's my perspective of what's happening, okay? Everybody is looking for the next big idea. Everybody is looking at what's at the end of the rainbow, but they forget to look at the diamonds in their hands. So that's what's happening. They have let go of all values, culture, because they want to go for the next big idea, next big technology. Everybody's so engrossed into that.
At the end of the day, I feel people want to be accepted. If a person is without a values, this no one would accept it. It's my take on the values thing is. So I feel that values should be there. It should not be compromised.
Very well said. And really, Vishnu, first we need to accept ourselves and then look at others accepting us. Now, I'm not saying accepting ourselves amounts to ego. It amounts to realizing a fact that I'm a human being, I'm not perfect, I make mistakes, I'm not proud of my mistakes, I learn from my mistakes, I won't repeat them, but I am not a mistake, which means I accept myself, I need to go continuous improvement, and that's it.
That was Shiv Khera in conversation with Susan, Payal and Vishnu. Thank you for watching the show. But be sure to be back to watch the next episode of Youth Express on Asianet News, same time, same day, next week.